From the common iliac arteries, we've seen the interiliac and the external iliac arteries. And I said that the external iliac artery is going to become the femoral artery, and that happens when it passes underneath a structure known as the inguinal ligament. We cannot see the inguinal ligament on this model, but the inguinal ligament connects from our anterior superior iliac spine to our pubic tubercle, which would be right about here. So if I drew a line across right about there, that would represent our inguinal ligament. So here would be an external iliac artery. On this side of the ligament, then, we would be the femoral artery. Now, the femoral artery supplies the majority of the blood to the lower extremity. The femoral artery travels in front of the pelvis and then travels initially along the medial aspect of the femur, and then will go through an opening in the adductor magnus muscle, known as the adductor hiatus, to pass posterior to the knee. When it passes posterior to the knee, it has gone through the adductor hiatus, it changes its name. So we started with common iliac. Under inguinal ligament, we became femoral. When we go through the adductor hiatus, we change the name to popliteal. The popliteal stops being popliteal when it branches into two branches, the anterior tibial artery and the posterior tibial artery. Now, the anterior tibial artery is going to pass lateral to the tibia and then run down the anterior aspect of the leg as anterior tibial artery and then out onto the top of the foot as the dorsalis pedis artery. The posterior tibial artery will send a branch out called the peroneal artery or the fibular artery. Now on this plaque, it disappears here because the fibula, you have to remember, is lateral, and we're looking at the medial side of this lower extremity. So the fibula is actually back away from us in this board. So this was the model maker's version of having this artery slowly disappear because it's getting further away from you. So this is the fibular or peroneal artery. This is the posterior tibial artery. Remember, here we had anterior tibial, now posterior tibial. Posterior tibial will go behind the medial malleolus of the ankle to become the medial and lateral plantar arteries. But because we're looking at a medial side of the foot, we know this must be the medial plantar artery. So let's jump back up to where we became the femoral artery. Femoral artery came down, went through the adductor hiatus, and became popliteal artery. Popliteal artery stopped when it became anterior and posterior tibial artery. But we've missed a whole lot along the way. Near the hip, there's a whole lot going on with this femoral artery. At the level of the pectineus muscle, we see a lot of branching going on. One branch that leaves the femoral artery will dive deep into the muscles, and that is this branch right here. It is called the deep femoral artery, also known as the profunda femoris. And it terminates as what are called perforating branches. And on this model, we can see one, two, perhaps three perforating branches of that profunda femoris, or deep femoral artery. Also, at that same level, we're going to send out two branches from the femoral artery, the lateral circumflex femoral artery and the medial circumflex femoral artery. The lateral circumflex femoral artery will branch into three branches, and it passes anterior to the femur. So we know from following these branches here, this is coming anterior to the femur, so this is our lateral circumflex femoral artery. On this model, they only depict two branches, the descending branch and the ascending branch. They do not have the third branch, but we know that this must be the lateral circumflex femoral artery because it's coming anterior to the femur. This other branch here is looping, and then we can see it passing posterior to the femur. That is this artist's representation of the medial circumflex femoral artery. So to recap, femoral artery, deep femoral or profunda femoris, lateral circumflex femoral artery coming anterior to the femur, medial circumflex femoral going posterior to the femur. And then we followed the rest down through this extremity. Let's hop over to the other extremity here for just a second Here we see the femoral artery, and in this model, they've cut that femoral artery so we can see those, better see the lateral and medial circumflex femoral arteries. But here we can see the femoral artery passing on down, and it's actually going to disappear behind the knee. Remember, we go through the adductor hiatus to go posterior to the knee. So back in here, where we can't see it, it is popliteal artery. Now again, we don't get to see the other branches from this view, except the anterior tibial artery, which we saw on this side, now comes in between the tibia and the fibula to travel down the anterior aspect of the leg and out onto the surface of the foot as the dorsalis pedis artery. Now there are other branches along the way, but we will not hold you responsible for them on this model. The veins are generally named with the same name as the arteries. So in this lower extremity here we saw the femoral artery. It's followed with the femoral vein. When it was popliteal artery, it was popliteal vein. The lateral and medial circumflex femorals have both arteries and veins. But the one big difference we see in the lower extremity, starting on the medial side of the foot and traveling all the way up the medial side of the leg, then the medial side of the thigh, to join the femoral vein just before it becomes the external iliac vein, is the great saphenous vein. The great saphenous vein. And this vein has many different clinical significances. I'll leave that up to your individual lecture professors. But great saphenous vein, medial side of leg, medial side of thigh, going into the femoral vein. Now that femoral vein, as it passes under the inguinal ligament, will become the external iliac vein. There are veins from the pelvis that were internal iliac veins. Those two will unite to form a common iliac vein. The common iliac veins unite to form the inferior vena cava. So those are the veins that you should be able to see on this vessel plaque.